Good morning to everyone. I am Radha Silaboina. Today I am going to present the paper on different thresholding techniques in image processing. It's a review proper under the guidance of Dr. Raju Vishwakarma sir. Coming to my main points, index, abstract, introduction, literature survey and methodologies what we are going to use and the conclusion. Coming to abstract, it is a generally every document will be containing some images or documenting data. So this data will be captured through optical scanning or digital video. So resulting a file which picture elements or pixels which serves as the raw input for the document analysis. So here these pixels are the sample incentives which will be given in the particular image with the grayscale image or normally RGB image. So grayscale images will be on 0 to 255 values for the color images. So here we are using a thresholding technique which will convert a grayscale or color image to a binary image so that we can reduce the noise and improve the whatever the main particular characteristics of that particular dot. So coming to the main goal of this paper is to focus on different thresholding techniques which are used in image processing. Nowadays we are also using in the computer vision. Introduction part. So here processing image may be containing the different textures, graphics, images, regions with the foreground and background attributes. So here image process or image segmentation, we have a process which will be analyzing the each and every field of the particular image or a particular with the different attributes and different features. So here the main problem with this particular document image will be, or document data will be, how to recognize that intensive values or pixel values. This is a very critical step in the particular digital image processing. So which will be later on particular pixels will be converting into picture image and pictorial to non-picture data representation. So subsequently this particular information we can use for image processing as a pattern recognition classification techniques so that we can use for the particular image. So here the main point of this particular document image will be how we are converting into the grayscale image or colored image or RGB image will be based on the binarization. So binarization is the process of converting any grayscale image into black, white image or two image. To perform binarization process, first we need to find the threshold value, so our grayscale value, so that we can check whether pixel is having a particular grayscale value or not. So this binarization process is very important in this particular one. Coming to literature review, so here any device, any digital image which are classified into binary or scalar, grayscale image or color image. So here we need to identify this particular image with the how this process of image processing steps will be converted: image acquisition, image pre-processing, segmentation, representation and description, object recognition. So this segmentation part will be the very important. This segmentation process we can call thresholding process or binarization process, so that we can have a representation of that particular image, so that by using some object recognition algorithms we can recognize the particular image of the particular attribute or particular characteristics of that particular documentation image. So coming to binarization, this binarization is a method of converting any grayscale image or into black or white image. To perform binarization process, first we need to find the threshold value of the grayscale and check whether the pixel is having a particular grayscale value or not. If the grayscale value of pixels is greater than a threshold, then pixels are converted into white. If similarly the grayscale of the pixels is lesser than threshold, those pixels are converted into black. So these particular this is the basic principle in binarization process. So based on the this binarization will be depends upon the different thresholding values, generally local or global or different based on the region also it is available. So these binarization will be based on the local or based on the global, based on the adaptive techniques, based on the multiple techniques. So here this particular image is showing binarization process. This is a general normal image that will be converted by using this binary image. So if the threshold value is greater than that particular value, then it will be converted into white. If the threshold value is lesser than particular value, it will convert into black. So these are the two images I given as some examples, sample images. So which will be after the original image and after the binary image process. Coming to the objective of this binarization is to mark pixels that belongings to true foreground regions or the background regions. So the main part is every document we need to identify what are the foreground features or what are the background regions. So these regions we can identify with the binarization process. For documents with a good contrast or components like the uniform background, binary scanners are available so that it will recognize with the digitalization process. Then thresholding will be converted into binary data. So many documents that have a wide range of background and objective incentives intensive, these fixed threshold values are recognized and foreground components and background components are separated with the clear picture. So this binarization is very, very important. This binarization process later on we can call as a threshold. So here, coming to methodologies, here in this paper, we have recognized the different thresholding techniques, which will be the local thresholding, global thresholding, adaptive and multi-level. So these are the different basic thresholding techniques which we are going to use in this paper. Coming to local thresholding, so it is assigning each pixel or small region of the document. So this local thresholding will be the binarization process which will convert a colored image into binary image. So this local will be any colored image we can convert into binary image so that it will be used for this local thresholding. Coming to global thresholding technique, here we are using single threshold value for the whole image, whereas your local thresholding technique will use a unique thresholding value. So this is the difference between this global and local. Okay, whole image we are using in one particular single pixel value. In local thresholding value, each pixel or region will be recognizing with that particular image or particular feature. So coming to adaptive thresholding techniques, this method where the thresholding value is calculated for the small regions and therefore there will be a different threshold values for the different regions. So here adaptive thresholding techniques will be used for them. Each threshold value is calculated for smaller regions, that may be background region or foreground region, so that it will be different threshold values for the different regions will be represented with the adaptive thresholding technique. Coming to multi-level thresholding, it is a process that segments a gray level image into several distinct regions. The basic technique which will be going to recognize with this particular multi-level thresholding is each given image with the segments will be cut into bright and regions so that one background color with the several objectives. So that is a multi-level thresholding technique. So coming to this conclusion part, so here we recognized as a survey, literature survey with the different thresholding techniques, but here day to day with the help of digital image processing or computer vision, day to day number of thresholding algorithms are developing. The main focus of this particular paper is what are the different thresholding techniques we are going to apply by the computer vision and the digital image processing. So this particular nowadays, this thresholding is a very, very important for implementing any algorithm based on this particular document images. So here we are recognizing, choosing a thresholding value is a very important in this particular image analysis and document binarization. So here in this paper, we are focusing different thresholding techniques and we are focusing how to choose each particular thresholding method or algorithm based on the documentation. Based on the different thresholding techniques. Here, best ways to choose any thresholding technique is, here we want to narrow the particular method description. Suppose local thresholding, suppose global thresholding. So here we are minimizing or narrowing the method description and experimenting with the different thresholding techniques so that we can also examine their results. So based on that only we are going to choose any particular thresholding technique. So here we are in this paper, we are mainly focusing on when we need to choose the local thresholding, when we need to choose the global thresholding, okay, when we need to trees are adaptive, when we need to choose the multi-level scheduling. So here in nowadays we are using OpenCV, Ofsted's algorithm, multi-level algorithm we are using, but here we are choosing a but here we are choosing a particular thresholding value which is based on the documentation binarization. So choosing a threshold method is very important in manager analysis and document binarization. So in this paper we are mainly focusing on the how to choose a different thresholding value and what are the different thresholding techniques we have. Digital image processing will be this particular digital image processing applications we are using in biometric recognition, fingerprint recognition, palm recognition, tissue layer recognition and military signal processing, different applications we are using this particular digital image So here coming to comparison, the conclusion part, we are not showing any results. Here we are concluding with the different comparisons where to use this particular image. In degraded, so in local, this particular local thresholding techniques which will be used in degraded document images where we can consider background noise or variation in the context and illumination exists. There exists many pixels which cannot be easily classified as a foreground and background color. Coming to global thresholding method, here we are in intensities distributed between different objects of foreground and backgrounds are very distinct. So the difference between this foreground and background objects are very distinct by using a single value of threshold, that is a use of this global thresholding technique. Coming to adaptive thresholding techniques, we can also call as a dynamic local thresholding techniques, which establishes the threshold level for the determining whether the convert to black or white or black region level. So these are the different comparisons as per my literature survey. We recognized where to use this particular global, local and multi-level thresholding technique. So these are the different thresholding techniques which I recognized with some particular picture, like local first initially local threshold and global threshold. Based on that characteristics which we are going to recognize with the this two combinations, also hybrid also it is possible. So these are the sample example, like even this is the original image. This original image will be converted into local thresholding, this will be converted into global thresholding. These are the samples which we are going to work on this particular cancer data, breast cancer data. So here we recognized with local and global data. So these are the references which we are used in this paper. Thank you everyone. Thank you for the opportunity in presenting a paper in ICDS MLA Third Conference. And also I need to thank with the college, CMRIT Institute of Technology. Thank you very much.